I recently said the worst thing you can possibly say to your wife or your girlfriend. Men, please heed my words. We were having an innocent conversation about me having a vasectomy. And I was trying to come up with reasonable objections, you know, like, oh, come on, please. And in my naivety, I said the worst thing. I said, but what if you died and I wanted to have children with somebody else? For some reason, women don't like that sort of talk. She reared herself up to her full 8'6" in height. And she said, so you're imagining me dead. And before I'm even cold in the ground, you're thinking of climbing up on somebody else. Who is she? Come on. Who is this whore you're so keen to inseminate? How do I die in this fantasy of yours? I'm so sorry. A tree falls in the car, but that's not important, love. It's not. I'm having an affair at the moment. With my wife, I should stress. It's just we're both very lazy people. And it's like a kind of a game we play. And it's something I'd like to share with you before I leave this game. I think you should try it if you need it. You know, I arrive home on a Tuesday afternoon pretending to be my wife's secret lover, wearing a cravat and clogs and special leggings that were left to me in a will. And we go up to the bedroom and we take all our clothes off, except for the leggings. And then we're about to get into bed. And she's going, oh, no, we shouldn't. I'm going, oh, we should. And what happens? Only this very good friend of ours called Tony calls around, pretending to be my wife's husband. And, are you with me? And I have to very quickly put on all my clothes and climb out the window and stay away for about 3 hours. So, yeah. So it's great fun. And my wife is much happier now, I'm glad to say. Yes. But I don't know about you, but I live in fear all the time. Fear, fear, fear. If it's not one thing, it is another. I fear crime. Tremendously. And of course, the drug addicts get the blame for everything, don't they? The poor old drug addicts, as if they don't have enough to be worrying about. I've been growing strawberries and raspberries in my garden lately, and I woke up the other morning to find they were all gone, stolen. Of course, I immediately assumed it was the drug addicts, so I hired a private detective to keep an eye on the shrubbery, and he discovered the true culprit was, in fact, my next-door neighbour, this old lady. And would you believe it, she'd been selling me pots of jam made with my own fruit. Yes. To feed her ferocious heroin habit, you know. You can't rely on anyone anymore. I was terrified in Montreal earlier today. I passed the shop window. It was full of essential oils. And I don't have any of them. And they're essential. I'm lucky to be alive here, ladies and gentlemen. Anyway, there's never enough time with these things. I wish I could stay here all night. There's never enough time in our lives, is there? We're short of time. It's the one commodity we're missing in our lives, isn't it? We all need more time. I was on a protest march in Dublin a few weeks ago, demanding more time. We were chanting, what do we want? More time. When do we want it? Now, I suppose. And then, I don't know what happened next. I had to go to a meeting. But anyway, thank you very much for listening to me. Good night, ladies and gentlemen. See you again. Thank you.